Hello and welcome, this is S tier rank. Today I want to play some more Inscription Casey's mod. Let's go ahead and get a new run started. We're going to go with the Mantis God and two Ringworm combo. That's been our usual here. I'm tempted to try single candle so that I can maybe avoid some of these harder ones. We'll do no boss rares and let's see how close this gets us. Not quite there. Maybe all totem battles. And these? Okay. And that prevents boss totems, so maybe this will be a better situation. Let's go ahead and give it a run. Have about an hour to do runs here, so if it ends within maybe 30 minutes, we'll try giving another run, so see what we can do. I'm gonna head for the fire events quickly, and let's go and get a Millworm and a Mantis, why not? Okay, let's see. I can't tell if that is a campfire event or not. Let's see. I don't really have a sigil swap to do yet. I could get another item, but it seems like a bit of a waste since I have two, so I'll try to use them up. Let's head to the woodcarver. Oh, I see a fire event too, so. Oh. Not a deploy. Let's get it. Even if we can't use it on our insects, maybe we'll find something strong with the three blood creature to use that for boost. Okay, Mole and Raven Egg. Looks like it's pretty easy choices. Put down our Mantis God and see what happens. It's gonna hop over, so let's just move in this guy down. Here we go. And we put down the ringworm just for fun. Let's keep running. Head to this fire event. Start buffing up something. I'm gonna stick with insects pretty strictly this time too. Okay, might boost. Okay, let's start using the flame here. Alright, well, way more than I can find. That'll be interesting. We'll probably boost up the other one, and hopefully that'll be enough to extinguish the flame. Ah. Can't get our ringworm that way. It's pretty hilarious. I'll take out the raven egg. Just one more swipe. Alright. Time for the Mantis God, I suppose. Man, it would be nice to sacrifice something to get one bone token to start with, because that would allow me to get quite a bit on the board rapidly. I'll do this, because I think overall it'll be a little bit more damage. At least I ain't going to do this one. Okay. Alright, let's see. I guess let's head up to our woodcarver and we'll do the next fire event. Ability, putting it on the Mantis might be interesting to make it stronger, so let's do that. It does cost me a bone too, so it would be good to have something that's bone related. Oh, unkillable, there we go. That's what we need. Now we just need an insect head, and I think that we will be fine and dandy. And dandy. Farm. Well, we can put down the ringworm that will take it out on the next turn. And I think that will be just fine. Oh, and it's waterborne. So that was my mistake. It's not gonna be taken care of anytime soon. I'll go ahead and pull a tooth because we're about to lose our ringworm to negligence. At least we're getting Millworm on the title here in a second. I think that might be all it takes to win the game. At least close to it. That mole is going to be a problem, of course. So we'll get buffed up here. And let's see. I guess we can take our squirrel and play it in front of this guy, because we can't lose. We only have one candlestick. There we go. Alright, time for the Mantis God. Let's see. I think that we can actually replace this guy, and that may do enough damage, these two being waterborne, to actually win the game. Good. Let's go with the three blood. Direwolf. Okay. And two fire events. Good. Surely we'll burn through one of these guys. Or maybe not. Maybe we'll just have us a ringworm army here. We can start boosting our Mantis God, or maybe our Millworm. Kind of hate to burn the Mantis here. So let's do the Mantis God and just do it once and back away. Our roundworms have been boosted enough that I think that they're actually a bit of an asset now. I kind of hate to get rid of them. Alright, bullfrog with strange frog and leaping trap. I think that we can handle this. We don't have any autumns though, so that's the only bummer here. Ringworm can take out a strange frog and die in the next turn, unfortunately. Then we put 2 damage on the board, so that's not good. But let's go ahead and I guess get that started. We'll get a pelt at least. Will be attacking this and this, the kingfisher we'll have to worry about. Get rid of the wolf cub, and another kingfisher's not a problem. This guy doing 3 damage might be a problem, although we can counter it with these other guys that we're about to get, so let's just go ahead and clear this column. Okay, and we'll put the bullfrog in front of it. There we go. And fancy is Wolverine coming to play too. I don't think it's going to be able to take anything out because we're going to win. Nice. I think soon I need to restock on items to be safer, but so far it's feeling like a decent match. And let's go ahead and get another ant into our fold here. Okay. Well, items or a power-up event. That's hard. There's also a cave event, too. I guess let's go with the left path. Buffing up my cards just doesn't seem to be the most rewarding thing right now. Alright, 4 power, 4 blood, or 6 health. 4 power seems like a hard one. Yeah, 4 blood, however. If we could get a dire wolf, we'd be in a pretty good spot. Or the ant queen would be decent too. 6 health. That doesn't feel very likely. I don't know, we have a mantis god, it's at 3. I guess let's go with blood. None of these were very advantageous. Hey, got it. Okay. Thanks for that dire wolf. Okay, field mice that have coonity and loose tail. Well, that's pretty sweet. Oh, hey there. Thanks for subscribing. At UB101. I'm gonna combine mantis onto mantis god. I'm not sure if it does anything, actually. I think that it may not allow it, actually, since they're separate and they have to be the same card, but it would be cool if he did something. Now I'm trying to decide if I want a mole that can have sharp quills and grow stronger, or field mice that have loose tail and fledgling. I think I'm going to go with the mole since it has a lower blood cost. But yeah, even with the sigils like combined up, I don't know if it'll do bifurcated strike and triple strike and double up in that direction, but it could. I just need to check it out, I guess. This is a tricky situation. I've seen this one before. I think getting the mole on the board makes a lot of sense because it'll grow stronger and it can hurt the prom more as it tries to do damage. So let's go with that. And I could have actually got the dire wolf on the board, but I think the pronghorn is gonna get hurt. Yeah, take itself out, so we might not have to worry about it. Now we have a mole man. Oh, that's a shame that it doesn't get some attack power. I thought it would, but at least it has a sharp quill, so it's kind of getting revenge for anybody that takes this on, so that's cool. Okay, let's see. I am interested to see if I can combine them, but I really need a totem first. And it stinks a little bit because there is a event up there, but I think I'm at a big risk if I don't get a totem completed, so I want to go that way instead. Alright. Pronghorn, tentacle monster, and a rattler. this one. I'm not exactly sure what Bell Ringer does. I need to research that one. I'll always say I'm gonna look it up, but then I never do. Let's see. Fortunately, I don't think I have any canons. Well, Wolverine may fall into that class. I'm not sure. We'll take it. Let's see. Reptilians. Not sure which ones they may cover either. I'm not sure if it covers this guy and the. Oh, I do have the Direwolf though, so let's take it for now. Ah, maybe actually doing the Corpse Eater would have been smarter, so the Direwolf would just deploy if something died and I had it in my hand. That's okay. Alright, Coyote is incoming, so we've got our buffed up Ringworms. And have a Millworm that's sitting there ready to go. So I guess let's go here for now. We'll attack the Coyote space and block from its hit. Okay. Now we have a Mantis, so we could safely play it. Well, actually, we're going to lose it. Well, we won't lose it since we have the extra. So that'll hit the Porcupine, we'll hit the Coyote and get rid of it. And they will do 3 damage on me, but we can take that hit. Oh, now we have a Sparrow incoming. Interesting. Alright, our Mole could be put on the board and take some of those hits. However, you see, with it becoming Mole Man, it would block the damage. So our Mantis would get +1 here, but this guy's gonna get 2, and then the Sparrow's gonna add a 3. So it's putting us pretty dangerously low, so I think I'm gonna go ahead and use up our Mole too, so that we can block some of that damage. Okay. Good, good. So let's put down another Ringworm as a damage blocker for the turn. Nice. Oh yeah. Yeah, the Corpse Wolf definitely would have been a better move. I think I just got excited with that earlier. I think that I'll have to swap that out if I don't get a chance at the what was it? At the insect head for the sigil. There we go. Cool. Sigil totem I want, so I think I want to go this route. Because if I can get it on insects, that would be the most ideal situation. Alright, Stinky Pronghorn. That's not a good thing to start with. However, I can put our Mantis God down and it should take it out. At least a good hit on it pretty quickly. And yeah, we'll do that. I think should get us enough damage on the board to, well, the mole's gonna come in and be a problem. However, maybe I'll address that as well. Let's see. Get a hit on the pronghorn, but that elk fawn's gonna be a problem, so I think I'd rather park this ant here in preparation for the elk fawn that's coming in. There we go. It also gets blocked with our mole being there. Okay. Let's draw from here. Oh, we could get us a buff ringworm going. There we go. Stinky is so annoying. Thankfully, Mantis God will take out this guy and almost take out the pronghorn, then the ringworm will finish it. Ah, and we can almost play our Wolverine, but not quite. So, let's put down our boulder and block off the elk fawn. This will be extra safe. Don't want to get any surprises here. Yep. That was the kind of surprise that I was thinking could come at us. There we go. Okay. So L has been tipped. Now we collect some rewards for our next boss fight. Let's do another three blood. Another direwolf. Cool. Maybe I will put down auto deploy wolves to give us the power on the board. I think, in fact, that will be the way we go. Thank you for the suggestion, Numi. Okay. Well, many lives. We do have sharp quills, but I don't think either of those can be beat by our wolf, so we'll go with it. Alright, maybe I'll get lucky and when he turns everything into gold nuggets, I'll have a wolf in my hand and can do an auto deploy. There we go. Put down ringworm to get a hit or two on this coyote. There we go. So the dire wolf will come out and smack it around. +4, and then wolf will do 3 on us, so we're only going to really move forward 1. Tempted to put down the mole, but maybe we'll just play this ringworm to take out the wolf. There we go. Don't have to worry. Actually, it'll just get hit by the Wolverine, and that's okay. That's what we can do. Alright, Dire Wolf should be coming on the board here in a minute. It's a wall man. It's extinguished. Okay, I didn't know. Holy Wolf was awesome. In fact, we could go ahead and get us another wolf. This may end up being a wolf hand after all. Okay. So, let's see. If I were to sacrifice anything, what would it be? Perhaps the millworm, so we can get us a wolverine more quickly. But there is a cave event, and I am down to just two items. Wouldn't mind going to the woodcarver again, but I've got a really good situation going. And currently, direwolf, I do have duplicates of it, and I believe that's it. Duplicate ringworms that could be combined up there. Let's do these two cave events and get our items full up again, and maybe we'll have a really good combo here. Ooh, three sigils. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 sigils. Two of kin, that may be a better deal. I think I'm gonna go with it. Oh, looks like we got it. Alright, Rabbit Warren has double strike and many lives. That could help get some other cards on, but a wolf cub that is a worthy sacrifice and would auto deploy and helps us find a card. I think that is highly, so it's worth it. Ooh, yeah, card cutting every time. And let's go with our fan there from Airborne. Sharp quills on insects. Not a huge fan of that idea. Let's see. Could play the mantis. These worker ants are gonna hit us pretty hard. Actually, they may have 5 damage worth off the bat. So that's not good. What do you think? Could block them with my body though, and that way our wolf cub auto deploys and it will help us find something as well. Yeah, let's just go with this. Okay, and that something that we find is going to be a mantis god card. Okay, now we have our wolf and it is a worthy sacrifice as well, so let's just go ahead and get our mantis god down, and it's going to take some hits, but I think that we're going to be okay. I think I want to cut a card, actually, so that we can have things survive a little bit longer here, and actually have a chance of getting out of this one alive. It's looking pretty bad if I didn't do that, I think. Now, I think we're on a healthy path. Good. Snapper that's airborne, that's kind of funny to imagine. Yeah, we'll go with this. Alright, who are we gonna combine up? Could have a strong ringworm. I guess direwolf is the way to go. 4 and 10 direwolf. Self deploys, that's pretty awesome. It's gonna be really tough and hard to stop. If it gets on just about any enemy, it'll last. Alright, mud turtle and flying ant that has wriggling or loose tail. The mole man could come in play here. I think that That feels like a great starting spot. Okay. No sharp quills, that'll teach them a bit of a lesson. Okay. And flying ant. Let's see. So that's going to get hit and die, I think. And then the mud turtle will do a decent amount of damage. And then flying ant will actually kill. So let's see. I think we'll do this so we can get our ant queen on the board. And we'll have it go after a flying ant, I suppose. So we don't want multiple ants on the board. We want Mole Man to hang out a little bit longer if we can. Okay. Come on, Mole Man. Do your thing. Alright, Ringworm. We're gonna do five damage right here, so let's put out our cockroach to take this guy out, and that'll be enough that I think it will be in a safe zone. Oh, the lady played some stinky cards out on me just now. So I think it's time to bring out our ringworm and then put a tail in front of the skink and block it. So that would be okay. And we'll just keep working our way. Actually, we can take out the mud turtle now because it doesn't have a shell. So, yeah, let's do that. Four. That's not good. Ah, nope. Miscalculated. I should have taken out the flying ant. I don't know what I was thinking with that one. Ah, darn. That was such a good run, too. We'll give it another try. Single candle is tough, but let's do it again. We'll call that a good warm-up. Going for 80 challenge points too, so I'm not entirely surprised. I guess we'll do a mix of canine and insects again. And let's head straight to the flames. Alright, come on, ringworm. It's your turn to roast. Oh, we got us a massively strong ringworm now. Okay. If only hitting it the second time, like alternated back and forth between health or damage, it would be amazing. Wow, why are you sitting out a Cody? Let's do us a wolf cub. Alright. And let's see. Well, that'll be an equal amount of damage, so we'll just play out. There we go. And we can get our ant queen now. Loser, unfortunately, but that is alright. So we'll have another worker out here, and together we're gonna beat it in that one turn with the wolf. Some time for our Mantis God. mole is gonna come over and block it from coming down anyways. Oh, maybe not. I forgot about the wolf being so powerful. So that worked out. I'll go for the excess damage run here. I think it will have just enough to hit something. Oh, not quite. I'm gonna try to hold on to my items just in case I notice a pack rat first run. And I see another fire event coming up too. Hey, good. Got us an insect bat this time. Okay. Mole and a pronghorn. Never liked those pronghorns, I'll tell you that. Mantis God is unfortunately really weak to start with. Could get, let's see, if we use a squirrel, we could get both in position right away. I think that I will just put down Mantis God and we'll use the Mantis next turn. We know we're gonna lose it. It may work out okay. Okay, and oh yeah, so let's see. Put them back over here, and that'll get us 3 damage on the board. Or not on the board because of the mole, but 3 heading out that way, and it blocks the pronghorn from moving out to, let's see, pelt. That won't be very useful at the moment. Alright, Mantis is going to get another hit in, and we can block it with this. That just moves it around, so we'll just keep going for the moment. I'd like to try for excess damage. Oh, an ant queen. Okay. Let's see. I may actually need to just go ahead and take this. I'm a little bit afraid about that Wolverine pronghorn combo going on here. Maybe I got a little ahead of myself there. I didn't want to use my items either, and being this close to getting a pack rat. Okay, magpie and a mud turtle and a skunk. I think I'll take the mud turtle. I might put its sigil on the mantis if I mantis god if I can't get a double strike. All right, let's see. We will boost up this ringworm and see if it takes away the flame. Like another strong ringworm situation is about to unfold here. It's pretty rare that I think that I've seen that made it through multiple campfires and not lose my ringworm like that, so I must have caught on to my strategy here. Alright, let's see if we can have a strong showing for this one. Cody. Put a mantis down, take it out, and golden pelt to block the coding. Okay, that's not bad. I think we can take these hits in stride, and let's see. Go ahead and pull a tooth so that the pack rat will replace our weakest card. Okay. There we go. Hey, black goat. That's a decent upgrade over the pliers. Unfortunately, well, actually, we'll have just enough for the pack rat to take us to the next phase, so we didn't use too many of our cards. Excellently, I think. Now we just gotta start hunting for our good cards in our hand. Let's see, Ringworm could take up a chunk of the Bloodhound. Okay, Mantis God. much easier if this isn't a sigil battle to you. Like, that's helping me quite nicely. Alright. Adder is going to be a little bit of a problem. The wolf cub's going to come down and take out our mantis god too. Do have to get the turtle on, but I think we'll just let it go for the next turn. Yeah. Because it didn't matter. I think I misread. I thought we need 3 more damage, but we didn't. 22. Wouldn't mind getting a little mod that turns the scale into a counter, make it a little easier to read. I wonder if I can switch that on somehow. Hey, putting that ability on Mantis God may be okay, just in case I don't get its power upgraded much. Maybe I could kill everything it touches. And we have an opportunity to make a duplicate Mantis God here as well. So let's see. I think I'll do that first. Might not be the best strategy overall, but just having 2 of them sounds really handy. This will give me an even copy. Like, I had one time where it didn't give me any attack power. Okay, good. So it was like 0 and 1, and I had to use a fire event to get it stronger. And boy, that was a tough one. Alright, flying ant and skinks. Okay. Well, wolf cub sounds pretty enticing here. So, I guess let's go with that. Okay, I should take out the skink in the back too. And let's see. We are a little bit of ways away. Another flying ant coming down though is going to be a threat. So we may need to finish this quickly. And could put a boulder down that doesn't block, so let's put the mantis down. That'll get 5 damage for the turn on the board. Okay, good. Okay, yeah, not the best situation now. Our skink is gonna be an issue, so let's use our boulder here. And that other flying ant is a problem too. So I think we're just going to have to put as much damage on the board as we can. And kind of hope for the best here, unfortunately. So that's actually +5, so that should win it. Okay. Good. We already got a pack rat card too, so having that desire met, it was worth spending some items. Okay, 4 power may be the best bet here. 4 blood. I don't know. Let's do 4 blood. Alright. Got it. Just barely. We got it. Black goat with both double strike and bifurcated strike. That's fascinating. It's hard to resist, actually. Bullfrog with rabbit hole and made of stone. That sounds like a tank. And a pronghorn that's made of stone and worthy sacrifice as well. I think let's do the black goat. If we can get this on the fire, that would be amazing. Plus, it's a black goat card, so you know it's gonna be great. Alright, something to sacrifice. Yeah, I'm not too happy with my choices. Perhaps that ringworm. I'd say that this one may not fit since it doesn't have any attack ability, so let's go with it. That did have good defense, so unfortunately. Okay, I think I need to head towards getting woodcarver stuff done because I don't have anything yet, so it's gonna be a tough road, but we'll do it. Hey, all right, we could get our black goat down, and since it's not useful, that helps get us an ant queen. And it is capable of withstanding the bullfrog, so let's do it. Okay, and that gets us a worker ant, so next turn we'll have enough striking power to take out the bullfrog. Ah, bullfrog is going to block the adder though, so that's unfortunate. So, and we do have a wolverine that's incoming. Let's see. Mantis could be ready to knock out adder. We don't want to feed the wolverine, so let's do our worker ant over here, and the next turn we'll get our mantis down in a minute, depending on how things are looking. Oh, rattler is incoming. Oh, this is just kind of going bad to worse, but we'll at least take out the rattler and do a little bit of damage on the wolverine. Oh man, they're throwing everything they have at me. Look at this. All I've got is a ringworm. Let's see. It may be worth it though, because they're about to do 4 damage on me if I don't get rid of that rattler. And then there's another rattler coming in, so it would do 6 damage on me. Tough. So if I get rid of the rattler, that's going to fully enable them to do 5 damage on me. And I don't think I'd be able to really draw enough cards to dig out of the situation. Amazing. Yeah, not looking good. So we may just have to play what we got and see how it goes. Alright. Let's see, we can't use our black goat card if this is something I value. Alright, it's a mud turtle. Alright, well that's enough to get rid of the rattler. However, they're gonna do too much damage on us. So they're gonna do 2 damage, and I won't be able to put anything on the board. At least I don't think so. Let's see, we'll check. Yeah, because we'd have to sacrifice. Unfortunately, we have to sacrifice the ringworm. They're gonna do 5. So, well, I feel like I didn't really have a misplay. Just a unfortunate sequence of cards here. So, yeah. Even if I blocked the rattler. Black goat still has to get sacrificed somehow, so I think we're gonna miss this by like 1 turn pretty much. Wow, and they're sending out an alpha too. Good grief. That match was amazingly one-sided. Wow. I'm gonna have to think about this. I don't know if single candle is gonna be beatable either. I've been kind of switching up strategies, so maybe next time we'll do totem again, and let's see what gets us up there. I don't like tip scales though, that's like my least favorite, so maybe we'll do something like more difficult and all these others, but single candle just runs into so many problems, and I need to find out what the ideal set of challenges for the 80 point run is, because I'm been on this one for a while now and not hitting a good strategy. I did have a few good ones with the Mantis God when I got double strike off of the Dire Wolf. But there's always some little trick that they use against you that ends up throwing things kind of sideways. But That's the way it goes. Okay, well, thanks for watching. It's been S Tier Rank. You can follow me on Twitch and Twitter at S Tier Rank, and I'll have a replay on YouTube soon. Thanks, and have a good day.